Welcome to this presentation. This is going to be a lecture about LES antennas. My name is Oscar Quevedo Teruel and I work at the KTH, Royal Institute of Technology. This presentation is funded a little bit by COSVISTA, that is our European action. So this lecture is going to be divided in different parts. Each of these parts will be a different video. In the first part, that is the introduction, I will tell you what is a LES antenna and what they are important to study. After that, we'll go to one type of lenses, that is homogeneous lenses. First, we will start with spherical shapes, and then we will deal with non-spherical shapes. After these homogeneous lenses, I will tell you what are the main limitations of homogeneous lenses, and also in general of all the type of lenses, that is aberrations and reflections. Then we will pass to a new chapter in which we will speak about getting in these lenses. And finally, I will try to introduce to you some new techniques that they are used or employed for the new generation of lens antennas. So this is the first part or block of this lecture, that is the introduction. Essentially, a lens antenna is an antenna that is composed of a feeding plus a lens. Traditionally, in the books, these lenses were considered as a type or particular case of aperture antennas, because essentially what we are doing is just to increase the aperture of our initial feeding. Lenses are very well known, particularly in the optical applications. Some very classical examples are, for instance, glasses. Here we have a picture I was taking with from wikia.com. So normally these lenses are used for avoiding aberrations that our eyes, that they are like an array of antennas, are having, so we can correct these small imperfections. But also can be used, for instance, in telescopes to look to the stars. Here we have a photo of Galileo that he was designing this instrument, that is a telescope, in order to look to the stars and to magnify the light that we were receiving from stars that they were far away. However, although these antennas were used a lot in the optical spectrum, they were not very much used in the microwave frequency band, even if they were, we can say, popular some decades ago. So the question is why they were not having this massive use in microwave applications, and the answer is this one. It's because essentially they are bulky. Here we have a photograph that I was taking with my laptop of a Lunenberg lens at KTH. So as you can see, I mean, it's something that is bulky. This is particularly designed for 12 GHz, but if we are going to lower frequency, this lens has to be larger. So they are expensive and also bulky, particularly when we have 3D configurations like this lens here. But however, in the last times, they were becoming very popular and are part of many research activities, essentially because in the new applications we are going in to high frequency bands, in the upper bound of the microwave regime, or also in the terrestrial regime. And we really believe that this type of lenses will be used in the new generation of radio telescopes, but also they can be used in communication systems like the future 5G, or even for high resolution scanners. in general, microwave lenses can be applied for two types of main systems. The first one is what we call imaging systems. That is to create, they are using to create an image of an object on the other side of our lens. Here we have an object, that is this small sphere, and here we have a lens. So essentially this object starts to emit a wave. This will arrive to our lens, and after the lens what we expect is that this wave can be confined also in a point that we call image. The other big type of applications that we have with microwave lenses is what we call antennas. Antennas can be used in reception or in transmission. In reception, essentially what we want to try to do is just to focus all the fields that they are coming from one direction in one single point that we call a receptor. So imagine that we have this object that is emitting some electromagnetic waves, and we have a lens in very, very far away in terms of wavelength. So we have a wave that is being emitted by this object. At a certain moment, these waves are to be very flat because we are very far away from the source, so it's what we call a plane wave. And this plane wave is going to incide in our lens that finally will converge in a focus. So we will place here our feeding or our antenna, and finally we can collect more energy or power that without the use of this lens. In transmission is the equivalent phenomena, but looking from the other side. So essentially what we want is just to transmit the energy from our source or our antenna that is more or less located in a single point, and we want to transmit this one in a certain or given direction. So this is our lens. We just have an emitter. This emitter is just emitting a wave that is arriving to our lens, and after this lens we will have something that is quite flat. So we are transmitting essentially in one direction, the direction of these blue arrows. When we are just speaking about lenses, essentially we are speaking about large devices in terms of wavelengths. This is similar to reflectors or arrays. Essentially we just make use of apertures that is bigger. Essentially we can just make antennas that are more directive, so we can focus better in one or different directions. In order to analyze this type of lenses, we normally use our ray or geometric optics, at least in the first step of design, because they are simpler. But when we have we go to advanced designs or second steps of our design process, we have to go to physical optics. And normally in the last step we will go to the physical theory in order to have a complete exact solution. So in this lecture, in all the different parts, I would like to focus in the analysis or the study of lenses, but we will do it with a designer perspective. So we will use full electromagnetic simulators in order to show how is the performance and which are the limitations and the operation of these lens antennas. So the first thing that we will just have to introduce from the point of view of the theory is the reflection and refraction theory. So essentially if we have two different media, one is called number two and number one, and we have an incident wave that is coming from an angle that is this with this showing that is I, that means incident. Essentially we will have two types of waves. We will have one wave that is the transmitted wave that is with this subindex t, and we'll have a reflected ray that is with this subindex that is r. So essentially we know that the sinus of the angle of incident divided by the phase velocity is proportional in all the different cases. Since this phase velocity depends on the refractive index of our wave, the incident and the reflected wave, they will have essentially the same angle because they are in the same media. But however, in the case that we are coming from one media and transmitting to another media, this angle has to be different because essentially our refractive index are different in the two different medias. If the refractive index of the second media, this one, is larger than the refractive index of the first media, number one, we will have always a refraction. We will have always transmission from one media to another one. However, if this is not true anymore, we need to look to this expression, because if the second refractive index in proportion is higher than the first one, than the sinus of is smaller than the sinus of theta in of the angle of incident, essentially what we will have is a total reflection. So we will not have transmission wave in the other side of the connection between the two different media. From the point of view of wave, if we have an incident wave, this incident wave just arrives to a transition between the two different media. We'll have two different waves, one wave that is reflected and the other one is refracted, as we can see in this graph. So since this media is essentially the same, the angle of incident and the angle of reflection will be the same, but however the angle of transmission will be slightly different. It's coming from the proportion between these two refractive indexes. As you can see, this media is a little bit denser than the other one, so the wavelength that we have in the second media is smaller than the wavelength that we have in the first media, because it's denser. But this is only giving information to us about the angles of incidence, reflection, transmission, but we need to know also something else, that is, how much is the amplitude of these fields. So essentially, to this one we have to go to the Fresnel formulae, in which we have an incident wave, a transmitted wave and a reflected wave, and we can make a difference between the amplitude that we have in the parallel plate and the parallel plane and the perpendicular one. So essentially we will have two coefficients that are just related by a sinus of the angle of incidence, and we have a wave that is because we have this exponential here. So when we transmit, we will transmit only an amount of the power, and when we reflect we will have also a power that is complementary to this one. So we will arrive in and we will reflect part of the power of the energy, and the other part will be transmitted. So how we know which is the proportion that is going through and reflected is coming from this next formulation. So we have two different components, for the parallel one and the perpendicular one. In this case for transmission, and in this case for reflections. And we have to get one conclusion here, and it's very very important that when we have two different media, N1 and N2, essentially we have always reflections, so we will never transmit all the power that it was arriving from the incident wave. And this is something important that we will deal later on in the next topics of lenses. So with this one we finalize the first part, that this was the introduction to lens antennas. Thank you very much.